In this how-to video, we'll cover how to set up relay outputs in a ProSense digital panel meter. I'm currently using a DPM2 model, part number DPM2-AT-2R-HL, that has two relay outputs. As you can see on the front of the display, there are two LEDs to display when relay 1 and relay 2 are turned on. I have a 4 to 20 milliamp signal from a pressure transmitter with a range of 0 to 100 PSI connected to this ProSense panel meter. The pressure transmitter is connected to an air compressor that has a maximum pressure of 60 PSI. In another video, we scaled our output to display the current pressure of our air compressor. Now we will set up the two relays with a high and a low alarm, so that the relays could tell an operator when the air pressure was too high or too low for production. First, we pressed enter, and we see PRO for program. Enter, and now we see I and P for input. Now let's press the right arrow key until we see SETP for set point, and then we press enter. We see SET1 for set point 1, and we press enter, and the display shows us 040.0. We want to set our low alarm to 8 PSI. We arrow over to the correct character and use the up arrow key to change our value. Now we press enter to accept the new value, and we now display high for our high alarm. We want to change to LO for our low alarm by using the right arrow key. We want our low alarm set for 8 PSI. We press enter to accept the low alarm, and we now see NO displayed for normally open on the contact. We can change to normally closed if we want, but we'll use normally open and press enter. We now see DLY for delay in case we want to set up a time delay before the alarm comes on. This is beneficial if your process is riding close to the upper or lower limits and may spike or drop below the set alarms momentarily. It would delay sending the alarm. We want to leave our delay at 0. So we press enter, and we see 000, and we press enter again, and it stores our setup. At this time, we only set up one relay for our low alarm. So let's go back and set up our high alarm on relay 2. Enter for program, enter for input. Now let's press the right arrow key until we see SETP for set point, and press enter. SET1, let's right arrow until we see SET2. This is for set point 2 or relay 2. Press enter, and now we see the value that was either previously set or is at factory default. Now here we have 060.0. Let's change that value to 15 for 15 PSI. We press enter. Now we see a high alarm, and we press enter. And we now see NO for normally open on the contact, and we press enter. We see DLY for delay. We want to leave our delay at 0, so we press enter. We see 000. We press enter again, and it stores our setup. So our operating range would be between 8 and 15 PSI. As we operate our air compressor, and if the pressure is below 8, relay 1 turns on. So let's simulate. We drop down to 6 PSI, and relay 1 did turn on. We turn our air compressor on. As our pressure increased past 15 PSI, our relay 2 turns on. This is how you set up the relays in the ProSense digital panel meters. They all pretty much set up the same in the DPM1, DPM2, and DPM3 meters that have relay outputs. If you look at the manual for the DPM2 models, you'll notice there's a way to access set points without entering the program mode. If I press enter, then the up arrow key, it takes us directly to set point 1 and set point 2 values. We can make changes and then save these values. This allows for easy adjustments to our set point values. I hope you found this video useful, and follow us to our other how-to videos on the ProSense digital panel meters. Thanks, and have a great day.